100%!
Woo! He's Norwegian, but he can speak fluent Russian. It's just in time. Woo! We got the equipment, we got the gaffer tape, so we are ready to start shooting. That's crazy. We're going to Oslo now, 30 minutes with car, to shoot the intro scene. And I don't know if I'm ready, so we'll see. Luckily I have Nils Eilif. Nils Eilif!
Hello!
He's a cinematographer. And I heard he's quite good, so we'll see.
We'll see.
What do you think about the Panasonic GH4?
I don't know yet.
We'll see.
Let's try it.
Yeah, you're mostly used to Arri Alexa and Red cameras.
Yes.
Yeah. Usually. So hopefully you manage to do.
It's gonna be fun.
Yeah. Looking forward to it. Okay. So let's go. We are now heading towards the first location. It's the intro scene with the hacker and his sister. And we're also going to meet one of the guys who bought the Mafia perk. He came all the way from Qatar. Looks like the weather is getting better, and it's now calculated that it's going to be sun the next days. So that's perfect. So perfect for the film.
Hi, come
here.
Hi.
He's a professional sound
master of sound. Yes.
Yeah. This is Mahesh from Qatar. Yep. He came from Qatar to Norway today.
Six and a half hours.
Yeah. He wanted to support the project by being accidentally shot in the film. Yeah. That's cool.
I've been waiting for it.
Cool. Hi.
Hello.
So Andrei is the hacker. Yeah, we have Dimitri, the guy who commented on my Facebook page and wanted to help out. He's from Estonia, so he can speak Russian. But do all people in Estonia speak Russian?
No, just who are the Russians.
Okay, so. Because we want the start of the film to be authentic. Tor André, the hacker, and Nikolina, they are not from Russia, they're from Norway, so we need some help from Dimitri to get it right. Okay, we're at the set for, or the location for the first scene, the intro scene. We have Nils Eilif preparing the camera, we're going to use the slider. So just like slow movements in the beginning. And then suddenly the action starts with the hacker and his sister running in into the room.
We wanted to start the whole scene in a wide angle shot to both reveal the room and to give the actors time to warm up before the close-ups. First, I show the crew and cast where I want the actors to move. This is called blocking, and it makes it easier for the cinematographer to place the camera and light and easier for the sound person to place the microphones. By setting up the camera, in this case the GH4 with aperture lens regain and Sigma 18-35mm, we could easily see how the lights would affect the scene and be sure to place them outside the frame. As we wanted the room to look a bit mystical and vivid to reflect the life of the characters, we found this pink lamp to use as a key light. And then we used the aperture Amran as main backlight, pretending it to come from a corridor lamp. This is called motivating lighting, as it imitates existing lights and makes it more credible. As you can see, we left one of the existing lamps on in the corridor. Existing light like this is called practical light. In addition of enhancing the atmosphere in this scene by adding props, such as the camera, the DVDs and the lava lamp, we used a small yet powerful lamp called Aperture M9 to imitate light coming from a helicopter. Moving light can give a nice effect when revealing objects. As this film is about cameras, I thought it'd be cool to reveal the first camera in a special way. As this was a tracking shot, it was important to pull focus. To change focus wirelessly, we used the Aperture Lens Regain remote controller. It was good, but the cat on the screen wasn't supposed to be there. The shot was a bit complicated and hard to achieve, as the technical part and the acting had to be perfectly timed. And as this was one of the opening shots, I really wanted it to be perfect. It was definitely a warm-up for the actors. After the wide-angle shot, we did the close-ups. We used almost the same light setup, but used the small aperture M9 lamp as an extra backlight. For sound recording, we used both a Sennheiser 416 shotgun microphone connected to a boom pole and two Sennheiser Evolution 100 wireless transmitters and receivers, with Sennheiser MKE2 lavalier microphones on the actors.
And as some of you know, there's a perk called That's My Scene, so 10 different people has gotten that scene. And this scene is Bruce Graham's scene, and it will send you a still image from this scene in your mail. So thank you so much for supporting. We had to make this guy look more evil, so we're using some mascara from Nicolina to get some more mustard and no, not mustard, mustache.
And this is Harald, a professional actor from Norway, who studied acting in Russia for 7 years. If you saw the last episode, I met him just the day before shooting.
I think for the web camera, it looks okay.
Yeah.
So we'll see for the close-ups on Saturday. Yeah. We'll probably do something else.
Should I put also some?
No. I think you're okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
For the last shot in the scene, the hacker called Eskil on Skype. This time, we used the Samyang 14mm lens, imitating a web camera.
Hello, Eskil. You need to download this hacker metal camera. Take good care of it.
As only two of the bad guys could show up for the shooting, I asked Nils Eilif, the cinematographer, to play the third bad guy. That's what I call frugal filmmaking.
Eskild Fors.
Veldig bra, veldig bra. Det var fint, altså.
It was day 2 and time to shoot the first scenes with Eskil at his place. Since Eskil has a full-time job in a bank, I had to carefully plan the shooting so we could finish most of his scenes during his spare time. So instead of shooting the scenes chronologically, we gather his scenes for the next coming days.
Oh no! It's the evil mob! Is that Jonathan Holdsworth?
No, he's actually one of the supporters. He chose the This Is My Scene perk, so this scene belongs to him. Thank you, Jonathan!
So the thing now, he's going to download the hack from the programmer. He has just sent it to Eskil. And since we didn't have made the hack yet, we just have a green screen with some tracking points, so we can add the software later. We're also going to do it on the camera. Yesterday we used the aperture 120T as a spotlight in through the window. And we used the blue gel and the umbrella to make like a kind of a soft moonlight. Today it's supposed to be early morning, so we have using the red gel, not using the umbrella to soft it, but have like a spot in through the window. So it will look more like morning. The C-stand is great because it's so strong, and when you're putting up a lamp high in the air outside when it's a bit windy and stuff, it's nice to have a really solid tripod or stand. So, let's start and shoot the morning scene.
As the room we shot in was quite small, we used a TV in another room as monitor. Here I could direct Eskil and also adjust the focus by again using the Aperture DSC lens regain.
Så lener jeg sakta opp og ser ut. Yeah, I think we should have a sliding shot towards his face to just enhance the situation that he actually sees that things disappears.
Maybe he could look at it more than once, more than twice, just to have the feeling.
Like, is this real?
Yeah.
Am I still dreaming?
Yeah.
Like that? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Test. Okay, bunk. Bunk. Tack. Kör bra. Den här. Kör bra.
We used the same Aperture 120T lamp for the corridor scene. We turned off all existing lights and made the 120T spot in through a small window. The lens we used in this scene was a Tamron 24-70mm, which has a built-in stabilizer that works great with the DEC.
My role is quite simple. I make the music, and today I'm going to make sure that every dialogue is read completely. We are just finishing shooting at Eskil's house, and we're now going to move the entire set to another place.
Yeah, we are at our friend's apartment. We are borrowing it because this is supposed to be my apartment in Oslo. He escapes, barely managed to escape by shooting two of them. He jumps into the car and drives to me. So we're going to shoot first that Eskil runs into the apartment outside. And since we are then already outside, we also shoot what happens after he's inside, so we film us two come out.
So now we're putting up the slider because inside if the cinematographer always wants to use the slider, he loves it. So I said, okay, you can use it again, even though we are a little bit delayed. So Eskil is coming with his Slobberok. We call it Slobberok in Norway.
I'm energizing myself with these little biscuits and some water.
Yeah.
Ready for running outside in my bathrobe. It's gonna be cold.
Klar ni, Salif? Okay, so this is the first scene we do together in this short film. So we'll see how it does, who plays the best.
Yeah.
I think maybe I'm a little bit better actor than Eskil.
We shall see.
We shall see. That was better, right?
Yeah.
Dag 3, tagning 30.
Thank you.
Fusco.
I slept really bad the last days.
You always do that before our shoot, don't you?
Yeah, I was thinking about everything.
Yeah.
Between earth and sky. You say that in Norway? Nils can't put the slider away. He wants to use it every shot. I said, we can just have a close-up on a tripod of me, but...
But I feel like if you still have it, just use it because it's so cool.
Yeah.
Some Native Americans still refuse to be photographed. This is based on a religious belief that a photograph could capture a soul, physically absorbing it within the light-sensitive crystals of a photographic film. Even after the shift to digital photography,
hello.
The myth.
Now it's getting late, so to make a kind of a daylight inside the room, we're going to use the Lightstorm LS1S, which is a daylight LED lamp, and just bounce it up in the ceiling to create a soft daylight look. If you haven't seen the video about this Lightstorm, check it out. It's called Film Look, I think. Film Look in... I don't remember. Check the channel. Don't be lazy.
I don't know what he's doing, but...
It looks great.
It looks cool. He studied at the best film school in Norway, so I guess he's doing something right. Even though it looks stupid. Okay, he just said to me that it's to block the light. It's more like a window feeling that the light is coming only this way. That was the reason.
Okay guys, let's do this!
Banana,
it's good.
Yes,
I'll
take a banana. I will eat it. There's the camera. Okay.
Potato
perfect.
Chips, anyone?
Woo!
We got it!
Whip! Jeg skal gjøre hva skjer.
Og så det her kamera. Det en... Det en hack. Som... Også mafiaen er etter meg.
Hva da?
Ser
du? Den henger der, den der kameraen.
Ja.
Ser du?
Hva?
Skal, her er jeg.
Skal, her er jeg. Ok, her er nummer to.
Har vi ikke flere?
Nei, det er egentlig det alt jeg har, tror jeg.
Ja, men her kan sluke strøm.
Okay, now it's the final shot for today. We're going to kill Mahesh with a camera. He's the first victim with a camera. So
I guess it's the third after Eskil kills two of them there.
But they surprise they get back their light.
Ah.
Almost kill them.
Okay.
So you're the first one that disappears totally. And also Mahesh has the That's My Scene perk. So it's kind of quite natural that this is his scene.
Yeah.
So congratulations.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Oh, I have to thank you. Okay, let's do this.
Again, we use the DC lens regain to make a fast and accurate focus pull from us to Mahesh.
366. Nu ruller.
Og vær så god.
Hei, hei.
Kom igjen.
Okay, woo! A clap for Mahesh!
Woo! It was day 3 and time to shoot the forest scenes. Luckily the weather was still on our side. Days of early location scouting proved to be smart. The owner of this cornfield didn't just let us film on his property. He also wanted to help out with shelter, coffee and a tractor. He said that if I wanted, I could use his tractor as a prop in the film. So, after a quick chat with the co-writer Thomas Leipold, we decided to add the tractor as a part of the story, as it would make the scene funnier and simply more exciting. However, changing the script in such a short notice can be risky, as it most likely will affect other scenes as well. But in this case, we figured out a way to do it.
Ett foto, varsågod. 5D og G4 batterier. Aldri har. Du Eskil, du. Og du Nix. Halla!
Halla.
Jeg følger dere på YouTube. Vi har ikke tid. Alle batteriene.
Jeg har det YouTube-prosjektet. Jeg driver og lager en kanal med traktorer.
Ja.
Vet du hvordan jeg kan skyte?
Hallo? Batteriene?
So, we went for the tractor. The challenge turned out to be a way to drive the tractor into the forest, where the scene was to happen. In addition, Truls, the actor, had never driven a tractor before. So yeah, we just had to try.
Det minner meg litt om den siste gaffeltrøkken jeg kjørte, altså. Det så vanskelig som de sier der?
Nei,
Okay, Truls, he has never driven a tractor before, so we were hoping he does it right, that doesn't smash the whole thing.
Okay,
let's see action. Any of us go?
Trenger dere noe hjelp, eller? Takk, det bra.
Skudd!
Jeg må tenke, vi må klippe litt så fleisk, så bare, er du ferdig snart? Så bare gå tilbake til oss.
Rop løp en gang.
And now we had to film the part with a shooting drone. And as you probably would have guessed, I wanted the most badass drone we could find. And luckily, a kind friend showed up with his DJI Inspire 1. Suddenly, it started to get quite windy, and the drone pilot had some problems flying it. Luckily, he was an experienced drone pilot, and we got the shots we needed.
Konge! Woo! Bra! Er du ferdig, Truls? Woo! It's a wrap, right? Good job.
Kjempebra, Truls.
Ja. Alle klapp. Vi møtes på søndag, da. Det gjør vi. Alle bare ta en klapp, da.
And the person with That's My Scene perk for this scene is Klaus Kunkel.
From Denmark.
Yes.
Jeg tar og dekker dere. Bare stikk uten meg. Jeg tar og dekker dem.
Okay. Er du sikker?
Jeg er sikker. Kom dere av gårde! Løp! Løp!
So far, so good. We had done well the first days, shooting one third of the film. However, this was just the warm-up.
I don't know who you are, but you're a big problem.
I'm writing, producing, coordinating, responsible for the whole crew to meet up, the cast, cars, the props, the locations, and I'm directing and acting at the same time. And I realize it's starting to affect the film in a negative way. But we just have to keep going.